So that's what we hope to demonstrate later this year, maybe as soon as 2 or 3 months from now.
Progress made in SpaceX Starship program later this year, likely in the next 2 to 3 months with Starship Flight 9. Contrary to what some might think, this flight does not signal a setback. Following the flight, Elon Musk and the SpaceX team quickly presented solutions to the challenges faced by Starship V2. Remarkably, these solutions are incorporated into the latest iteration of Starship. Today, we'll go into detail about the innovative improvements. Let's talk more in today's episode of NR Studio. On May 29th, Elon Musk spoke to an audience at SpaceX Expansive Star Factory, where he outlined improvements scheduled for the new version of Starship. These improvements are clearly designed to help the spacecraft reach a major milestone in its quest to realize its Mars exploration ambitions. The main focus of Musk's presentation was the upgraded Raptor 3 engines. Ahead of Starship Flight 9, SpaceX has revealed plans to introduce the Raptor 3, which promises improved reliability to improve upon previous failure mechanisms. Musk expressed high hopes for these engines, describing them as alien engines, capable of achieving unprecedented levels of performance. In order to achieve this goal, the design underwent significant simplification, integrating the secondary fluidic circuitry and electronics directly within the engine structure for increased protection and containment, an impressive engineering feat. The Raptor 3, which will be featured on Starship version 3, offers substantial improvements over its predecessor, the Raptor 2. It will produce 269 tons of thrust at 350 bars of chamber pressure compared to the Raptor 2, 230 tons at sea level, and 258 tons in a vacuum. By eliminating the need for engine heat shields, the Raptor 3 reduces weight while increasing reliability, allowing small fuel leaks to disperse harmlessly into the plasma stream during reentry. Elon Musk emphasized the Raptor 3 simplified design, which combines the secondary fluidic circuitry and electronics, increasing efficiency and minimizing potential points of failure. These advances allow the super heavy booster to produce an astonishing 9,000 tons of thrust with its 33 engines, significantly reducing the likelihood of engine-related failures. Additionally, the lack of heat shields simplifies maintenance, making it easier to reuse quickly. This really makes the Raptor engine revolutionary, especially in terms of mass reduction and increased reliability. Another important improvement highlighted by Musk is the improved heat shield. As we know, the heat shield has become a critical component. Challenges facing the Starship program. Insights from Elon Musk. In a recent discussion, Elon Musk highlighted one of the many daunting challenges facing the Starship program: developing a truly reusable heat shield. Historically, no organization has successfully engineered an orbital heat shield that can be efficiently reused. The challenge is compounded by the fact that even the space shuttle's heat shield required extensive repairs months after each mission. Despite these hurdles, Musk emphasized SpaceX's unwavering commitment to creating a heat shield that can be reused quickly, potentially hundreds of times. To address the wear and tear seen on the second generation Starship heat shield, the upcoming version, known as Starship V3, features a redesigned heat shield design. The revision features smoother, more aerodynamic contours, and eliminates protruding tiles. The front flaps have been strategically repositioned closer to the nose of the spacecraft. They are now thinner and angled to minimize exposure to reentry plasma, reducing the damage that occurred during previous flights. The primary heat shield will consist of 18,000 hexagonal silica-based tiles that will be supported by an enhanced secondary ablative layer, likely made of pion-based materials to increase durability. In addition to these innovations, SpaceX is investigating the potential for retropulsive reentry using Raptor 3 engines. This approach could reduce reliance on the heat shield itself, simplifying the overall process of reusing the vehicle. The advancements are aimed at ensuring that the heat shield can survive the rigors of reentry not only on Earth but also on Mars, where the planet's CO2-rich atmosphere poses unique oxidation challenges. Another significant improvement in Starship V3 is an increase in fuel capacity, coupled with the addition of more engines. This new iteration of Starship will see its height extended by about 20 meters, bringing the total stack height to about 142 meters. Fuel capacity will increase to about 4,000 tons, up from 3,700 tons in version 2. The upper stage will now be equipped with 9 Raptor engines, 6 designed for sea level and 3 optimized for vacuum operations, compared to V2, which had 6 engines. The upgrade is expected to result in increased thrust, increasing payload capacity to 200 tons for reusable missions and 400 tons for single-use missions to low Earth orbit. Including the super heavy thrusters, Starship V3 will have a total of 42 engines, a nod to Musk's humorous reference to the meaning of life. The increased propellant capacity and thrust are projected to reduce the number of refueling launches required for future Mars missions from 8 to 5. Moving forward, upcoming upgrades for Starship 3 will introduce a redesigned connection between Starship and its thrusters, commonly known as hot staging. Musk expressed optimism about this development, stating, "We're currently developing the next generation of Starship that will incorporate a number of improvements over the existing model. It will be taller and more efficient. As SpaceX continues to innovate, the pursuit of a fully reusable and efficient Starship heat shield remains a key focus for the future of space exploration. The redesigned Starship features an improved interstage, which facilitates a more efficient connection between the spacecraft and its boosters. The prominent support structure, or strut, allows for easier ejection of the flame during the warm-up stage. This innovative warm-up stage design, reminiscent of the early Starship 2024 concept, takes inspiration from the Soviet Union's N1 rocket. Elon Musk highlighted the increased protection this design offers for the propellant tanks, shielding them from the intense pressures generated by the Raptor engines during separation. During the warm-up stage, where the spacecraft's engines are firing while the boosters are still burning, the new interstage's open struts allow for smoother ejection of the spacecraft's engine flames. The interstage, along with its supporting struts, will be recovered rather than discarded. The V3 design also incorporates an elliptical common bulkhead for the propellant tanks, which optimizes capacity and structural integrity. These improvements are intended to reduce propellant leakage, prevent ignition issues, and improve mission reliability. A significant improvement expected in future versions of Starship is an improved control system. To address the tumbling issues observed during Starship 52 re-entry flight, SpaceX is implementing an advanced control mechanism in Starship V3. This includes backup systems and adaptive algorithms designed to maintain stability during the high-pressure conditions of re-entry. The front flaps have been redesigned, repositioned to leeward, thinned, and tilted to reduce exposure to re-entry plasma and improve maneuverability. Combined with the increased number of engines, now 9 Raptor engines, this provides significantly greater control authority. Elon Musk emphasized the importance of reliable control to achieve precise tower capture, critical to rapid reusability. In addition, the radar system on the launch tower, Chopsticks, has been significantly improved, allowing for more accurate tracking during thrusters and recovery of the ship. The increased height of Starship version 3 requires infrastructure upgrades, with the total stack height being approximately 12 meters. SpaceX is developing a new launch tower and orbital launch stand with updated quick disconnect gear to accommodate the dimensions of the V3 and support the higher launch cadence. A second launch tower is also under construction at Starbase, Texas. In a significant move to scale up operations, SpaceX is expanding its facilities, including a new location in Florida. The expansion is aimed at increasing production capabilities, specifically targeting mass production of Starship V3 at an impressive rate of 1 ship every 2 to 3 weeks, with an ambitious annual goal of reaching 1,000 ships. Once this upgraded infrastructure is fully operational, SpaceX aims to have weekly launches by mid-2026, supporting mass production of Starship, which is essential for Mars colonization while ensuring scalability and operational efficiency. A key advancement in this framework is the advancement of orbital propellant transfer technology. This critical development is integral to the Starship V3 mission to Mars, with a demonstration scheduled for 2025. Elon Musk emphasized the importance of this technology, stating, "One of the other technologies that is critical for Mars is orbital propellant transfer. While this technology is still complex and has yet to be successfully demonstrated, Musk and SpaceX are committed to innovating solutions for transferring cryogenic fluids in space. With Starship V3 estimated thrust of around 4,000 tons and an improved docking system modeled after the Dragon capsule's successful interaction with the International Space Station, in-orbit refueling between starships could soon become a reality. These advances are anticipated to significantly reduce the number of launches required for refueling missions, shortening turnaround times, and dramatically increasing Starship's reusability. Elon Musk aims for an orbital refueling demonstration to occur as early as next year. Collectively, these developments are working toward creating a unique vehicle capable of achieving the ambitious goal of colonizing Mars. The coming years are poised to be crucial for SpaceX as the company seeks to solidify this vision and make a quantum leap toward deep space exploration. In his broader vision, Musk has stated his intention to minimize his involvement in government affairs to concentrate on his businesses, which include SpaceX and Tesla, a maker of electric vehicles and batteries. He acknowledged that the timeline for reaching Mars is highly dependent on Starship overcoming several technical challenges during development for test flights, particularly related to the in-orbit refueling maneuver after launch. The late 2026 timeframe coincides with a rare alignment between Mars and Earth, which provides the optimal time for a trip, as it offers the shortest journey between the two planets, which typically takes about 7 to 9 months. Musk estimates a 50-50th chance of meeting this deadline. If Starship isn't ready by then, SpaceX will delay its efforts by another 2 years. The first flight to Mars is expected to carry a simulated crew of Tesla-designed humanoid robots known as Optimus, with human crews scheduled for subsequent missions. Musk envisions launching between 1,000 and 2,000 Starships every 2 years to establish a sustainable, long-term human presence on Mars. In the meantime, NASA aims to return humans to the Moon aboard Starship as early as 2027, marking more than 50 years since the last crewed Apollo landing, as a stepping stone to sending astronauts to Mars in the 2030s. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode, and thank you for your support.